Okay, with your partner, I want you to spend a few minutes doing three practice problems, okay? You get to pick your own problems. So let's say Belinda and Vincent are working together. Vincent will pick a two-digit number, like 32. You see this box up here?
Yeah.
This box is just in case you need to regroup. They just put a box there so you can regroup and put the 10 there. If you don't need to regroup, you don't need to use it, okay? But you're going to write the number underneath the box. Vincent will pick a two-digit number. Belinda will pick a one-digit number. Both of you add. Then you check your answer. If you get both get the same answer, then good. Move on. If you have different answers, then both of you go back and check and see what the problem is. Okay. Next problem. Belinda picks a two-digit number. Vincent picks a one-digit number. Check it, add it, check it with your partner. And then do the third one as well. Any questions?
Uh-huh.
Yes, Hillary.
Is it okay to do it by your own?
No, you're doing this with your partners. And,
Oh yeah, you gotta do
I would like you to stay under 100 today. Pick a two-digit number under 100, okay? Okay, give that a try. Go. Pick a two-digit number. Stephanie, pick a two-digit number.
22.
22. Let's write down 22. 22. Okay. Riley, pick a one-digit number to add.
8.
Okay. Write it down. Right. Can I? You know, I think I did this too fast. Can you look up here? I didn't show this clearly enough to you. Eyes up here. Some of you are having trouble when you're writing your numbers. If your number is 77 plus 4, that's okay. But write the two-digit number first, then add the one-digit number. It's just a little bit easier this way. Okay? And remember, save that box right there. That box is for you to, in case you need to regroup a 10. All right? Okay. Go ahead and get started again. So 77 plus 5, right? Okay, so 5 ones plus 7 ones is how many ones?
12.
Okay, you write down what you think, he'll write down what he thinks. So go ahead and write 12 ones. But can you put that two numbers in the ones place? No. Take 10 ones and trade it for a 10.
Uh-huh.
But why'd you erase the two ones? Look. In the number 12, right? That's the same thing as one group of 10 and two ones, right? So you take the group of 10, you trade it for a 10, so you have two ones left. You can think of it this way. You take the one in the tens place, you bring it over here, you have two ones left. Does that make sense? Okay. All right? Okay. Now you have to add the tens. 7 tens plus 1 10?
8.
Uh-huh. So fix that. Mm-hmm. Did you have to regroup? All right, let's go ahead. If you did not finish this partner part, I need you to go back and do it. But let's go ahead and open up to the guided practice and independent practice. Okay. Let's read the directions together. Ready? Go. Use connecting cubes and your work mat. Add. Did you need... I don't have everyone reading. Let's start right here. 1, 2, ready, read. Did you need to regroup? Circle yes or no. Okay. Today we did not use our cubes and our place value mat, but if you need it, the cubes are there, the place value mat is there. If you need it, go ahead and use it if this is getting hard for you. If you can do it on paper, then move straight on to doing it on paper. Okay, we already did a lot of practice together, so I'm going to have you do this The guided practice on your own. This is kind of like your independent practice today. Okay, so you're going to do the entire thing on your own. Do you have to do the do you understand?
Yes.
Okay, let's read it together. Ready? Go. Suppose sum of the ones is zero. Oh, not zero, ten. What do you write in the ones place of the sum? Let's read it again. Ready? Go. Suppose the sum of the ones is 10. Stop. Suppose the sum of the ones is 10. That means pretend or maybe. Okay? So let's see. If you have a number and you're adding it up, and suppose the sum of the ones, the sum of the ones, that means when you add the ones, the sum is 10. Like that. Okay? So suppose the sum of the ones place is 10. What do you write in the ones place? So if the answer is 10, can we put 10 there?
No.
What do we write in the ones place?
One in the 10 place and a zero in the ones.
I'll let you think about that one, okay? Any questions? Eric? Oh no, any questions on the whole thing? I want you to think about this for a while, then we'll go over it. Okay, please begin. Jaden, look. 6 plus 5 is not 1, it's 11. You're supposed to regroup. Okay. Oh, and over here, what's going on here? 3 ones plus 6 ones is 9 ones. Did you need to regroup? Did you need to do that? No. Okay, try that again. I think you're going too fast. Okay, did you need to regroup here?
No.
No, then circle no. Did you need to regroup here?
Yes. Yeah.
Then? And then you have to show me. Okay, if you don't show me, then how can that 3 tens turn into 4 tens? You have to show me. If we have 6, you added 6 more ones, okay? Do we have more than 10 ones? Do we need to regroup? No, so that's the answer. 2 tens. 2 tens. And how many ones? Okay, do you need to get cubes? Or are you okay with this? Kevin, you were doing such a good job with the whiteboard. Let's try it without the blocks first and see if you can get it. And then if not, we'll use the blocks again, okay? So you and Karina already did a really good job here. It seems like you get it.
He was with Elton.
Oh, that's right. Elton, yeah, you guys did good here. So let's see if you can try this without using the blocks.
Okay.
So let's start adding. Should we start in the ones place or the tens place?
Tens.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Remember what we said? When we're adding, we're just putting it all together. So we can start here or we can start here. But it makes it easier to start in the ones place because in case you need to regroup, then you can just add it in. Okay, so let's start here. 3 ones plus 6 ones.
9.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And then 2 tens plus 0 tens.
0.
No, 2 plus 0?
2.
Yes. Did you need to regroup there? No, that's it. Circle no. Kaylin, use your touch math if you need to. What's 8 ones plus 5 ones? Do you remember how to use touch math? Okay. What's 8 plus 5? Okay, let's put the bigger number in our head. Okay, bigger number in your head, then touch 5 more. Go, 8, you touch it. 9, 10, okay. But can we write 13 ones there? No, so you knew that already, so you did that already, okay? Now let's add the tens. 4 10 plus 1 10 is how many tens altogether? Okay. So when you were doing with the blocks, that's what you did, right? You added the ones, then you regrouped. Okay? You can do it. You can continue doing it with the blocks if you want to, or if you feel comfortable doing it this way, you can do it this way. Okay? Okay. Suppose the sum of the ones is 10. So let's say if you add the 1, suppose the sum is 10. What do you write in the ones place? Try this one again. There's something wrong here. Try this again. 1 plus 7 is 8. Do you need to regroup? Cái cần đổi ở cái 10 không? Không cần thì sao có ở đây? Okay, boys and girls, we're going to go ahead and spend a little bit more time on this. I think after lunch, because we have Ben coming here for guided reading. So, let's put this away in your desk, and we'll take it out after lunch to continue. If you use blocks and place value mats, please put it back where they belong and check and go do your job. Okay.